In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a liquid drip effect very easily in After Effects, so let's jump to it. First, let's create a new composition. It will be 1920 by 1080, 30 frames per second. Click OK. You can apply this effect to text, logos, and shape layers, but I'll be using text as the example, so let's select the type tool and type something. Let's go for liquid. For the font, I'm using Montserrat Black with a size of 350 pixels in all caps. Let's open the Align tab and align the text to the center of the composition. Then let's open Effects and Presets window and search for CC Smear. Add it to the text layer or any layer in your case. Then let's head over to the Effect Controls panel. Here we will find From and To Points. Let's select this button for the From point. Then choose the area that you want to apply drip effect to. Let's say this first letter I. So I'm going to come to the bottom edge of the letter I, then slightly up above it. So we leave some space between the edge and the area like that. Then click the point for the two button, align it with the first one. You can see that it is like straight. So like click a point here, then zoom out to the composition and bring this 2 points slightly outside of the composition like that. Now move the time indicator to the start of the timeline, create a keyframe for reach, set the value to be 0. Then move a bit forward in the timeline, let's say 2 seconds, increase the reach. And as you do, you can see the drip effect taking place. So keep increasing it to maybe 600. And if we look closely, you'll see that the edge of the area or the letter is staying distorted after the drip, and that looks very nice. Now I'm going to select the layer, press U on the keyboard to see the keyframes, drag and select them both, right click any of them. Keyframe assistant, easy ease, or press F9 as a shortcut to easy ease the keyframes. Now let's open the graph editor, right click, make sure edit speed graph is selected. Then select the first point to the left, you'll see the yellow handles, and drag the first yellow handle all the way to the right, and that's how the graph should look. Now, if we exit the graph editor and preview the animation, we should have a very nice and smooth drip effect. And after we've created one drip effect, we can easily select it in the Effect Controls panel and press Ctrl D to duplicate it. And here we have CC Smear 2. Again, we can click a point for the From, then choose a different area, different letter, let's say the letter D. So come to the bottom edge, then slightly above, like that, click a point. And do the same for the 2 point, align with the first one, zoom out, and bring it outside of the composition. Now, if we preview this, we will have 2 drip effects taking place at the same time. But if we look closely, you can see that the drip effect itself is not wide enough for the letter D. You can see that it's not affecting this edge at all. And for that, we can easily increase the radius for the CC Smear 2. So let's start increasing it. You can see more of the area is being affected. So let's say this one to 100. And now if we preview, we should have a lot wider of a drip happening. And at this point, if you look here, you can see that the gap sort of closes too quickly at this point. If that's something you like, you can leave it as it is. But if you want to extend this gap further, you can simply select the From point and bring it slightly up like this. And you can see that extends the gap all the way. And that may look better depending on your preferences. And also you might need to come back to the last keyframe of the reach and increase the value so the edge is not too distorted. So the maximum is 1000 and you can keep it at 1000. So now if we preview, you'll see nice drip effects. And you can also press U twice on the selected layer to see all of the keyframes and offset them in time. So the drips happen at different times. And at this point, it is up to you to create as many CC Smear duplicates as you like and place them in different areas to affect different letters and stuff like that. And that's how you create a drip effect. Very simple in After Effects. I hope you enjoyed and learned something new. Thank you guys for watching. See you in the next one. Peace out.